Hello guys, and today I'm going to show you my review of the Acer Nitro 5. So before you start the video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. And with that being said, let's get started. The Acer Nitro 5 for under $700 is a great gaming laptop that features a good build, a good looking 1080p display, and some of the best performance you'll find for the price. The build quality and design of the laptop is actually quite good even for a gaming laptop. With the laptop, you get a black casing with colored accents on the hinge as well as on the border of the trackpad, and has a fully plastic build that is decent for the price, but it would have been better to have seen a metal type build on this. Still, it is also quite subdued looking for a gaming laptop and overall doesn't have a gamery look to it, which I actually quite prefer. The Nitro 5 is also quite thin and light for a gaming laptop, weighing in at around 2.5 kilos. The connectivity and port selection is quite solid as well. With this, you get 3 USB ports, 1 USB 3 and 2 USB 2, a USB Type-C port, HDMI port, a Ethernet port, a SD card slot, a headphone microphone combo jack and power in. This pretty much includes all the necessities as well as some extras like you would expect out of a gaming laptop. The keyboard and trackpad are also good and better than average. The keyboard layout is classic Acer style, which comes with most of their laptops. It features chiclet keys and a single colored backlighting that can only change to red, but still it's better than if it didn't have it at all. Resistance in travel is fine, and it is a keyboard that should cater for more than just the basic needs. The trackpad on this is decent. It is quite large, making it comfortable to use and makes it easier to use multi-touch gestures and such. Other than that, the tracking is accurate and should be good for most light work. Audio on the laptop isn't very good at all. The speakers especially sound quite poor. You get a very teeny sound from them, which don't result in a good experience. Volume is also not very impressive, as it is not even capable of filling a medium-sized room. However, at least the DAC for the headphones is quite good, and I would highly recommend using headphones for any kind of media consumption and gaming with this laptop. The display on the laptop is good, but not that great. It comes with a 15.6 inch Full HD IPS panel that offers good looking colors and contrast, great sharpness, decent viewing angles, and really good brightness. The display could just be one of the brightest gaming laptop panels out there, but it does lack a bit in viewing angles as it gets a bit washed out when looking at it from another angle. Other than that, the display should be good for most things such as watching videos, gaming, and even a bit of editing. Performance on the laptop is easily the biggest reason to buy the Nitro 5. Its specs include the Intel Core i5-7700HQ processor, 8GB of RAM, a 256GB SSD, and the NVIDIA Geforce GTX 1050 Ti. These are easily the best specs I've seen for the price, and the only weakness here is the lack of storage right out of the box, but you can easily upgrade that quite easily as well. The star of the show in terms of the laptop's performance is easily the 4GB NVIDIA Geforce GTX 1050 Ti, which will let you play every game outright now on the highest settings and 1080p resolution, which is great for a laptop at this price bracket. Editing is also doable, with it being easily able to edit videos up to 1080p resolution. Thermals on the laptop are very good as well. It stays quiet and cool most of the times even when gaming, and the large vents on the back for cooling do a great job at staying silent even at high loads. Battery life on this is however decent at best. You can make it last up to 4 hours on a single charge, which is quite lower than the average of around 6 hours, and while gaming, it goes down even more. So the final verdict for the Acer Nitro 5 is that it offers some incredible specs, a good build and a good looking display. Overall, in my opinion, if you are in need for a laptop for gaming, editing or even any work, then this laptop could just be the best laptop you can buy for under $700. So that's it for the video guys, thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to the channel, and I hope you enjoyed the video. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.